Discuss about factors influencing vibrational frequencies in IR spectroscopy. In the previous videos, we have already calculated vibrational frequency, and I said that it is found the calculated value of frequency of absorption, and the value which is obtained from the spectrum is never exactly equal. So here, coming to the first point, the vibrational frequencies or wave number of absorption can be calculated by using Hooke's law. We have already studied about that calculation. If you did not watch that video, the link is given in the description. Please do watch it. Next, we know that we will calculate vibrational frequencies or wave number of absorption by using Hooke's law. And it has been found that calculated value of frequency of absorption for particular bond is never exactly equal to its experimental value. So now our topic is, what are the factors which are responsible for shifting of the vibrational frequencies from their normal values? It is our topic. So here I have listed some of the factors which are responsible for shifting of vibrational frequencies from normal values. Those are coupled vibrations, Fermi resonance, electronic effect. In electronic effect, we'll study about inductive effect, mesomeric effect, and also in field effect. And last one is hydrogen bonds. These are the main factors which are responsible for shifting of vibrational frequencies from the normal values. Now let's study the coupled vibration. What are these coupled vibrations? Now in coupled vibration, let's read the first point. An isolated CH bond exhibits one stretching frequency. We know that if we consider the CH bond, it has only one stretching frequency. It can have only one stretching frequency. Whereas in the case of methylene, that is in the CH2 group, what happens means two absorption occurs because of symmetric and asymmetric stretching. See the structure of this CH2 here. Here is a C and here are the two hydrogen atoms. Here this can exhibit symmetric stretching and also asymmetric stretching. Symmetric stretching means both are moving away from the central atom. Whereas in the asymmetric stretching, one is moving away. That is, one is stretching and one is coming towards this atom. That means here both the bonds are stretching in the same direction. So it is called as symmetric stretching. Whereas in the asymmetric stretching, one bond is stretching in this direction and other bond is stretching exactly opposite to the first direction. So it is asymmetric stretching. But in the case of CH bond, there is only one stretching frequency. But whereas in the case of CH2 group, there are two stretchings, that is symmetric stretching and asymmetric stretching vibrations. Because of these two symmetric and asymmetric vibrations, we will get two absorptions, that is two absorption frequencies. See here, in such cases, asymmetric vibrations always occur at higher wave number. So see here, asymmetric stretching is having the wave number, that is frequency of absorption, that is 2926, whereas symmetric stretching is having 2850 centimeter inwards. As you can see, asymmetric stretching is occurred at higher wave number. So these are called as coupled vibrations. In a same molecule, there are two different vibrations. So these are coupled vibrations, that are symmetric and asymmetric vibrations. Not only in the case of methylene, we can also observe this in the case of CH3 group also. See here, it is the symmetric stretching. Every bond is stretching in this direction only. But in the asymmetric stretching, these two bonds are stretching in this direction and this one is coming towards this central atom. So it is asymmetric stretching. Please remember that in coupled vibrations, asymmetric vibrations always occur at higher wave number. This is the most important one. Now coming to the Fermi resonance. This Fermi resonance was given by Enrico Fermi. He observed it in the case of CO2 first. In the Fermi resonance, here matching the frequency of fundamental and first overtone or combination band takes place. It is called as Fermi resonance. I will explain you detailedly. See here, this is the mu 0 and this is the mu 1 and these are the mu 2. These are the vibrational energy levels. We know that these are vibrational energy levels. So here, if a molecule make a transition from mu 0 to mu 1, this is a fundamental transition. This is the basic concept. This is a fundamental transition. When the molecule make a transition from mu 0 to mu 1, then it is called as fundamental transition. But what is overtone? If the molecule make a transition from mu 0 to mu 2 through the fundamental band, that is mu 1, it is called as overtone. That is mu 0 to mu 1 is nothing but fundamental, whereas mu 0 to mu 2, it is called as overtone. And the frequency of overtone is double of that fundamental transition. So if the frequency of this fundamental and the frequency of this overtone matches, means then the Fermi resonance occurs. We can understand it by taking example. So first let us see the example. It is given by aldehydes in which CH stretching absorption usually appears as doublet, that is 2820 centimeter inwards and 2720 centimeter inwards. So in the case of aldehydes, this CH stretching is usually appears as a doublet. It is a doublet. Let's assume this as a doublet. This is having the value 2820 centimeter inwards absorption frequency, and whereas this peak is having the frequency, that is 2720 centimeter inwards. This peak is due to fundamental and this peak is due to overtone, and they are having the approximate gap, that is 100 centimeter inwards. And you can see that these two frequencies are matching each other, that means they are equal to each other, that is they are nearly equal to each other, then we will tell them as they are having same frequency, or matching of frequency is taken place in the fundamental and overtone. Overtone value should be double of that fundamental, but here in this case, your fundamental is having 2820 centimeter inverse and overtone is having 2720 centimeter inverse. Here the matching of frequency between this fundamental and overtone has taken place, so it is called as Fermi resonance. And here we are considered the example of aldehyde. So this absorption frequency is due to fundamental and this is due to the overtone. Important difference between coupled vibration and Fermi resonance is, in coupled vibration we will have two fundamental vibrations, whereas in the Fermi resonance one is fundamental and other is overtone or combination. Now let's study the other factor, that is electronic effect. Now coming to the electronic effect, the changes in the absorption frequencies for a particular group takes place when the substituents in the neighborhood of that particular group are changed. Here, that means when the different substituents are added in the neighborhood, then the absorption frequencies will also change. So the frequency shifts are due to electronic effects, which included, that is inductive effect, mesomeric effect and field effect. Let's study them one by one detailedly. So under the influence of these effects, the force constant or bond strength changes and its absorption frequency shift from normal values. We know the formula, that is B bar is equals to 1 by 2 pi C root of K divided by M1 M2 divided by M1 plus M2. Here you can see this wave number is directly proportional to the force constant, that is K. So this force constant increases means then the bond strength also increases. Please remember that these two are directly proportional. So the wave number increases means this force constant will also increase, so that the bond strength will also increase. So now coming to the inductive effect. Now we have to know what is inductive effect. So here, shifting of electrons in covalent bond from low electronegative atom to high electronegative atom. So here in this example you can observe that this Cl is electronegative atom. So here what happens means shifting of the electrons in a covalent bond takes place from low electronegative atom to the high electronegative atom. So here the electron density will move towards the electronegative atom, that is Cl. The electron density will move towards the Cl. That means shifting of electrons is taken place from the low electronegative atom to the high electronegative atom. So this will get partial negative charge and this will get partial positive charge. And this carbon and this Cl will also have this effect. So this will have less effect than this first carbon. So it is having the less effect. Whereas this third carbon is also having the effect, this inductive effect, but not more than these two carbon atoms. So it will get, and you have to remember that the electrons will shift towards the high electronegative atom. So the electrons are shifting towards the Cl. This is about the inductive effect. So there are two types of inductive effect, that is plus I and minus I. We have to study about them also to understand it better. Now let's study about the minus I effect first. So these three carbon atoms, let's consider it as a system and this as a group. Here the group has more electronegativity than the system. This type of effect is called as minus I effect. Whereas in the plus I effect, what happens means here it is a system and here it is a group. This group is having less electronegativity than the system. So this type of effect is known as plus I effect. Here I have said in the minus I effect, the group is more electronegative. That means electron withdrawing groups must be present. For example, NO2, F, Cl, Br, I, CO and Cn. These are the electron withdrawing groups. Please remember that minus I effect means electron withdrawing group, whereas plus I effect means electron donating group must be present in this place. That means electron donating groups are alkyl groups. We know that CH3, CH2, CH3. This is about the plus I effect. Plus I means electron donating group must be present, and minus I effect means electron withdrawing group must be present. Now let's study this point. Introduction of electronegative groups or atom, that is electron withdrawing group, causes minus induction effect. We already know that. I have said that if electronegative groups or electron withdrawing groups present means then it is minus I effect. So which results in the bond strength to increase. So here what happens means electron density shifting towards this electronegative atom, then automatically bond strength will increase. And I have said that what happens, bond strength is increased means what has been increased, force constant is also increased. So here force constant is increased means what happens means wave number also increases. So I have said this formula, wave number is equals to 1 by 2 pi c root of k divided by m1 m2 divided by m1 plus m2. Here wave number is directly proportional to the force constant. So here force constant is rising because of the increase of bond strength. So here force constant is increasing means automatically wave number is also, wave number will also increase. So minus I effect rises the wave number of absorption. Let's read this point once again. Introduction of electronegative group or atoms, that is electron withdrawing groups, causes minus induction effect, which results in bond strength to increase. The force constant increases and hence the wave number of absorption also rises. So let's take some example and understand it better. So consider these examples. First, let's study about the acetone. Here acetone CH3 C double bond O CH3, it is having the wave number, that is absorption frequency 1750 centimeter inwards. Only here we are studying about the CO absorption frequency. Here in the acetone it is having 1750 centimeter inwards. Now let's study chloroacetone. In the chloroacetone, here you can observe Cl. So it is electron withdrawing group. Here induction effect takes place. That is negative induction, minus I effect takes place. If minus I effect takes place, means what happens? Wave number of absorption rises. So in the case of acetone, here is CH3, CO, CH3. But in the case of chloroacetone, one H is replaced by Cl. So automatically what happened? Absorption is rising. That is 1725 centimeter inwards is the frequency of absorption in chloroacetone. Why? Because here the minus I effect is taken place. Now coming to the next example, that is CH3CO CHCl2. Here let's study about this CO absorption frequency. Here how many Cl are present? Two Cls are present. Here also minus induction effect has taken place. So here in the dichloroacetone it is 1740 centimeter inwards is the frequency of absorption. Now coming to the tetrachloroacetone. In the tetrachloroacetone, see here, compare with acetone. Here in the place of two hydrogen atoms, 2 Cl has came, and here also in the place of 2 hydrogen atoms 2 Cl has came. So here are 4 Cl atoms are present. So the absorption frequency is 1750 centimeter inwards. Why? Because here also minus I effect is increased, so the absorption of frequency is also increased. So here compare from acetone to tetrachloroacetone. As the number of electronegative groups or electron withdrawing groups are increased, the absorption of frequency also rises. Now coming to the plus I effect. What is the effect of this plus I effect? Here introduction of alkyl group, you can also say alkyl group or electron donating group, which causes plus I effect. We already know that, which results in the weakening of bond. So if the alkyl groups are present, means then the lengthening or weakening of bond will take place. So the force constant will decrease. That means bond strength decreases, means what happens? Force constant will also decrease. If the force constant is decreasing, means what happens? Wave number also decreases. So the plus I effect will decrease the frequency of absorption. Let's take some examples and understand it better. So for example, consider formaldehyde. Here it is having 1750 centimeter inverse frequency of absorption. Now coming to the acetaldehyde. In the acetaldehyde, here is the CH, that is alkyl group. Compare the structure of formaldehyde and acetaldehyde. Here HCOH, but here is CHCOH. So the difference is this much only, but the absorption of frequency is decreased. Why? Because introduction of alkyl group has taken place. So here the absorption of frequency is 1745 centimeter inverse, which is less than that of the formaldehyde. Now coming to the acetone. In the acetone you can observe that here is a CH3 and here is also a CH3. You can see that the alkyl group has been introduced in this group. So here compare the structure with formaldehyde. In the place of H, here is a CH3, and in the place of H, here is also a CH3. So due to the presence of two CH3 groups, there is a decrease in absorption of frequency. So here is 1750 centimeter inverse is the absorption frequency in the acetone. Why? Because of the plus I effect. And remember that minus I effect will increase absorption, that is frequency of absorption, plus I will decrease absorption frequency. This is about the induction effect. Now let's study about the mesomeric effect. Now coming to the mesomeric effect, here in the mesomeric effect we will study about plus M effect and minus M effect. So this mesomeric effect will occur in the case of conjugated system. What is conjugated system means they should have alternative double bond and single bond. Those are called as conjugated systems. And coming to the first point, it causes lengthening or the weakening of bond, leading to the lowering of absorption frequency. So this mesomeric effect causes lengthening or weakening of bond, which leads to the lowering of absorption of frequency. Now let's study what is this mesomeric effect and how it affects the absorption frequency. So coming to the definition, it refers to the polarity produced in a molecule as a result of interaction between two pi bonds or a pi bond and a lone pair of electrons. So here in a molecule, if the polarity is produced, which is the result of interaction between two pi bonds or a one pi bond or lone pair of electrons. So you can understand this definition by the examples very clearly. So first let's study about the plus M effect and minus M effect so that you can understand this mesomeric effect very effectively. I have said that here mesomeric effect means conjugated system should be present, that means alternative single or double bond should be present. Here you can observe in this example, it is a single bond, it is a single bond, double bond, like this. So here let's study about the plus M effect first. So when a group completely transfers lone pair of electrons to a conjugated system through resonance, the group is known as plus M group. That means for the plus M effect, what should be present? Lone pair of electrons should be must. So when the group transfers lone pair of electrons to a conjugated system, so it is a conjugated system, here the lone pairs are present. So here these lone pairs are transferred to this conjugated system through resonance. So this type of group is known as plus M group. For the plus M group, there should be lone pair of electrons. Please remember that. So these lone pair of electrons should be transferred to the conjugated system. So this lone pair will move towards here, whereas this bond, that is pi bond, will move towards here, and this bond will move towards here. So here it will become, after the transfer of lone pair of electrons, here this NH2 will get a positive charge. Why? Because it has given its electrons. And here this single bond, after getting electrons, it will become double bond, and here is a CH, and this bond is shifted towards here, so it will become single bond, and here is the CH, and this single bond will become double bond, and here is the CH, and this bond is move towards this carbon atom, so that carbon atom will get minus charge, and here is the CH2. So here you can observe that here is a plus and here is a minus. What happened at the end of this? Here is a plus and here is a minus. So that means polarities produced, poles are produced. And I have said that in the definition that it refers to polarity produced in a molecule. Here you can see polarity is produced in the molecule. And here, so as a result of interaction between two pi bonds or a pi bond and a lone pair of electron. Here the interaction of a pi bond and a lone pair of electron has taken place and we will get a plus m effect. Please remember that in plus m effect there should be lone pair of electrons that should be transferred to the conjugated system through resonance. Here resonance has happened, so it is plus m effect, and the polarity has also produced. Now let's study about the minus m effect. So in the plus m effect, lone pair of electrons are needed. But in the minus m effect, what happens means when a group completely takes off pi electrons from a conjugated system through resonance, the group is known as minus m group. In the plus m effect, these lone pair of electrons are transferred to the conjugated system. But in the minus m effect, what happens means pi electrons are taken out from a conjugated system through the resonance. Such group is known as minus m group. So let's study it with an example. So let's see this example. CH2 double bond, CH single bond, C double bond O. Here in the minus effect, what should happen? Pi electrons are removed from the conjugated system. So here this bond will move towards here. What happens means pi electrons are taken out from a conjugated system. So here two bonds are present and this bond will move towards here, and whereas this bond will move towards here. So here also resonance has been taken place. Here for the mesomeric effect, resonance is the most important thing, and here after the transfer of this bond to here, this will get CH2 will get a positive charge, and here is CH, and here will get an double bond. Why? Because here this bond has moved towards here and we will get C, and this double bond will become single bond. Why? Because these pi electrons are moved towards the oxygen. This oxygen will get a negative charge. So here we have observed that pi electrons are taken out from the conjugated system through the resonance. So such type of effect is known as minus m effect. And you have to remember that in the mesomeric effect, lengthening or weakening of bond takes place, which leading to the lowering of absorption frequency. So let's study some of the example to understand it better. Now coming to the first point, it causes lengthening or weakening of bond leading to the lowering of absorption frequency. And in the second point, in most of the cases mesomeric effect works along with inductive effect. So in a same molecule, both mesomeric effect and inductive effect will be present. So in few cases, what happens means this inductive effect will dominate over the mesomeric effect. So the inductive effect will dominate over the mesomeric effect. So let's consider some of the examples. And you have to remember that in a compound, if both inductive effect and mesomeric effect is present, means in few cases inductive effect will dominate over the mesomeric effect. So let's study some of the example. Here it is a methyl vinyl ketone and second one is acetophenone. So let's study this first A, that is methyl vinyl ketone. Let's study whether here is a mesomeric effect present or not. Here for the mesomeric effect, that is, let's study about the plus M effect. Why? Because here lone pair of electrons are present. Here lone pair of electrons are present means these lone pair of electrons will move towards the conjugated system. That is, they are transferred to the conjugated system and the polarity for the compound is produced. So here is a plus M effect. Why? Because here the lone pair of electrons, we know that already. And here is inductive effect is also present. Why? Because here oxygen is electronegative and here electronegative atom is present, means what effect is produced? Minus effect, that is minus I effect is produced. I have said that electron withdrawing group is present, means minus effect, that is minus I effect will be produced. So here minus I effect is also produced, that is plus M and minus I are produced. So in this case also, in the case of acetophenone also, what happens? One pair of electrons are also present. That means minus, that is plus M effect, and here is a electronegative atom, so here is a minus I effect. So plus M and minus I effect are present. And you have to remember that if the conjugation is more, then frequency will decrease. That is, frequency of absorption will decrease. That's why in the mesomeric effect, absorption of frequency is lower. That means in the mesomeric effect, conjugated systems are present. So here, in the case of methyl vinyl ketone and acetophenone, minus I effect is dominated by mesomeric effect. Here the effect, mesomeric effect, is more. So if minus I and plus M are present, means in most of the cases mesomeric effect is dominated. In few cases only inductive effect dominates over mesomeric effect. So here if minus I and plus M are present, means mesomeric effect only dominates. If the mesomeric effect is more, means then the absorption of frequency is lower. So the absorption of frequency is less in both A and B. Please remember that inductive effect, mesomeric effect present means mesomeric effect only dominates in the most cases. Only in the few cases inductive effect is dominated over the mesomeric effect. So now coming to the next example, let's study about benzamide and phenyl acetate. Here let us compare the absorption frequencies of these amides and esters, that is benzamide and phenyl acetate. So this benzamide is having absorption frequency, that is 1693 centimeter inwards, whereas this ester, that is phenyl acetate, is having 1730 centimeter inwards. As you can see here, it is the nitrogen, it is having lone pair of electrons, and here is the oxygen, which is also having lone pair of electrons. Here in the ester also you can see, here both are oxygens only, but in the case of benzamide, one is nitrogen and other one is oxygen. First case, that is in the benzamide case, here nitrogen is less electronegative than the oxygen atom. So this nitrogen lone pair of electrons is involved in the conjugation more, that is it participates more in the conjugation. That is, lone pair of electrons on the nitrogen will participate more in conjugation as compared to oxygen. Why? Because electronegativity of nitrogen is less, so it participates more in the conjugation compared to oxygen. So here coming to the phenyl acetate, here both are oxygens only, so they will takes place less part in the conjugation. So I have said that if conjugation is more, frequency of absorption is less. So in the benzamide it is 1693 centimeter inwards, that is centimeter inwards, and in the esters 1730 centimeter inwards. So compare these two. Here the frequency of this benzamide is less, and the frequency of absorption of this phenyl acetate is more. Why? Because the lone pair of electrons on the nitrogen takes part more in conjugation. That's why the absorption of frequency is less. Here in this case both are oxygens only, so the participation in the conjugation is less, so increases the absorption frequency. Here it decreases the absorption frequency. This is about the mesomeric effect. And you have to remember that in the mesomeric effect, conjugation takes place. Conjugation always reduces the absorption frequency. This is about the mesomeric effect. Now let's move to the field effect. So, field effect. In ortho-substituted compounds, the lone pair of electrons on two atoms influence each other through space interactions and change the vibrational frequencies of both groups. This effect is known as field effect. You have to remember that the field effect is observed in the ortho-substituted compounds. So, let's consider an example, ortho-halo-acetophenone. here, in this you can observe that here is one atom and here is one atom. This is oxygen and here is the halogen. Here the lone pair of electrons present on this oxygen atom and the halogen atom causes electronic repulsions. So these two causes electronic repulsions. So when the electronic repulsions are increased, this result in the change in the state of hybridization of this C double bond O group. So here consider this example. In this group here is a two atoms which are having lone pair on the oxygen atom and lone pair on the halogen atom. So these two causes electronic repulsions and this results in the change in state of hybridization in the CO group. So when the electronic repulsions are increased, then what happens? Conjugation will get disappeared. So the conjugation is diminished and the absorption occurs at higher wave number. If the conjugation is less, then the frequency of absorption is higher. I have already said that to you. So here, due to the electrostatic repulsions, conjugation is decreased, so the absorption occurs at higher wave number. So this field effect is seen in the case of ortho substituted compounds, and thus for substituted compounds, that is for ortho substituted compounds, cis isomer observes at higher frequency than the trans isomers. If the field effect is shown by ortho substituted compounds, in such cases cis isomers will have higher wave frequency than the trans isomers. Let's study about the hydrogen bonding. Hydrogen bonding brings about remarkable downward in the frequency shifts. This hydrogen bonding will also decrease the absorption frequency. So we have to know what is hydrogen bonding. It is a bond between a hydrogen. We know that hydrogen is highly electropositive element, and you have to remember that hydrogen bonding means it is a bond between hydrogen, which is highly electropositive element, and highly electronegative elements such as nitrogen, oxygen and fluorine. So it is a bond between hydrogen and highly electronegative atoms like oxygen, nitrogen, like this. So this is known as hydrogen bond. This hydrogen is electropositive and this nitrogen is electronegative, and this hydrogen bonding will lesser the absorption frequency. So stronger the H bonding, greater is the absorption shift towards the lower wave number. If the hydrogen bonding is stronger, then the absorption frequency is lower. That means wave number decreases than the normal values. So you have to remember that in the hydrogen bonding we are having intermolecular hydrogen bonding and intramolecular hydrogen bonding. So here intermolecular hydrogen bonding means we know that it is a hydrogen bond which is present between two atoms of two different molecules. So here it is one molecule and here is another molecule, and here is a electronegative atom and here is the electropositive hydrogen. So here this is one molecule and this is another molecule. If the bond between this, that is hydrogen bond between these two molecules has been taken place, means it is intermolecular hydrogen bonding. And intramolecular hydrogen bonding means in the same atom hydrogen bond is present, means then it is known as intra. Intra means within, inter means between. So intra, here is a molecule, it is only one molecule. In this one molecule only, if hydrogen bond is present, means if the hydrogen bond is present in the same molecule, then it is called as intramolecular hydrogen bonding. So here is the oxygen and here is the hydrogen. So here is a bond, that is hydrogen bond, which is in the same molecule. So it is intramolecular hydrogen bonding. And you have to remember that bands due to intramolecular hydrogen bonding are sharp, whereas intermolecular hydrogen bands give rise to broad bands. Remember that intra means sharp band, Inter means broad bands. And this intermolecular hydrogen bonding is concentration dependent. So if the solution become more dilute and dilute, intermolecular hydrogen bonding will disappear. Please remember that. And this intermolecular hydrogen bonding is independent of concentration. If the solution becomes more dilute, means also hydrogen bonding will not disappear in the case of intramolecular hydrogen bonding. And next point is, mostly non-associating solvents like CHCl3, CCl4, CS2 are used because solvents like acetone and benzene influence OH and NH compounds to greater extent. So if these solvents, that is acetone and benzene, are used, means they influence OH and NH compounds. That means they associate with the compounds. But whereas if we take the solvents like CHCl3, CCl4, CS2, these will not form hydrogen bonding with the sample. So these are called as non-associating solvents. So these CHCl3, CCl4, CS2 are most preferred than the acetone and benzene in many cases. Why? Because if the associating solvents present, means they will influence OH and NH compounds to greater extent. So I have said that hydrogen bonding will lower the frequency of absorption. So let's study by taking it example. So in amines, we will observe NH stretching. In amines, we will observe NH stretching is at 3500 centimeter inwards before hydrogen bonding. When the hydrogen bonding is not present, in the amines, NH stretching is at 3500 centimeter inwards. But after the hydrogen bonding, what happens means absorption occurs at 3300 centimeter inwards after the hydrogen bonding. In the amines, NH stretching is at 3500 centimeter inwards before hydrogen bonding. And after hydrogen bonding, NH stretching is at 3300 centimeter inwards. So after hydrogen bonding, what happened means here the frequency is lowered. Frequency of absorption is lowered. So I have said that if stronger the hydrogen bonding, lower is the frequency of absorption. Please remember that. And in the case of amines, NH stretching is at 3500 centimeter inwards before hydrogen bonding, and after the hydrogen bonding, it has been reduced to 3300 centimeter inwards. Please do share with your friends. Thank you for watching.